Oh. Hi everyone. It's early. I'm on the Veluwe, large nature reserve in the middle of the Netherlands. Lots of wooded area, and I'm trying to see if I can spot any deer or roe deer or maybe wild boar. There's lots of wild boar over here as well, so haven't seen anything yet. But let's see what we can come up with. You might notice something here in these woods, that the underlayer until a certain height is all clear. That's because there are so many deer over here. They're practically grazing away everything, which is easy to eat, especially in the winter. They will eat all the buds, and yeah. What results in this? You can occasionally look really far away. It is great to spot wildlife, because you can look with the binoculars, really far away. And as long as you keep quiet, yeah. I think that's one of the biggest sign in the Netherlands, because it pretty much covers the whole Veluwe area. Those roads are great as leading lights. If there would be a deer or something at the end, that's really awesome. There's a bit of a clearing as here as well, so I better approach quietly and see if something might be grazing over there. Never know. So while I'm walking, I'm now walking in the middle on the grassy bit of the road, because that's giving the least sound at the moment. There's also the tracks where the car tires would be, but those stones, those are chirping if I would be walking over there. So it has been raining the past few days, so where the grass is, that's all wet right now, so I can walk really quietly over there. If it's bone dry, then actually walking on the sand might be quieter. So whenever it has been raining a lot, it's a lot easier to walk around quietly through the woods. Occasionally you can even walk over the leaves, and as long as you take your time, you make very little noise. Was awesome. So I was walking a bit further up the road, And then a whole group of wild boar came with small ones, proper piglets with stripes. So they didn't really notice me, and they were foraging around. So I got off the side of the road and they were walking around some trees. So they were foraging and they were disappearing into the woods. And I thought that was it. So I walked on. I didn't vlog it, sorry. No time for vlogging. When they are that close, that was way there, that was too cool. So, but I continued walking. And then between, I think they are called blueberries, those bushes. There were more wild boar foraging. Adults, and they were really close up. So I could make, because the road was a bit lower than the forest floor, so I could hide myself by simply ducking down a little bit. So these wild boar were foraging, and I could get a few shots where they were really hidden between the blueberries. Oh, hope those photos worked out. I love wild boar. It's amazing to see such large animals walking around in the woods. And as long as there's some distance, they do not mind humans at all either. So they make good wildlife photography subjects. And I love this one. He still has some tufts of winter hair around his ears. So the camera I have with me is the A7 R4. It's morning and it's quite dark. So I do not bring my 200 to 600, but my 70 to 200 G Master lens, because, well, it's enough zoom for large mammals. And with the 1.4 teleconverter, I still have like 280 millimeters. Stag beetles. There's three males and a female. And there's also a male further up. Oh, and they're fighting as well. These insects are huge. I believe they are the largest insects living on land. In the early summer, they can be found on oak trees. The females are looking for spots where moisture is coming out of the oak. Then males are attracted to the females, looking for a chance to mate with them.
How cool is that? I have to see what I can do with this. You see, this tree has almost no branches. So it might be cool to photograph them from below and that you can see the branches above. Oh, the cool thing is that they are pretty low. They are about on my height of my face, so I can really easily make some photos. The only problem is I have a big zoom, and if I want to show the canopy from the tree, I really need a wide angle. Two possible solutions for that. One is I use my mobile phone. I have an S10 with a wide angle lens, but that offers little possibilities with the depth of field. And I have this vlogging camera, which is a 2.8 16mm. So first I'm going to try and use my mobile phone. It's not bad, but with my mobile phone, but I think I will try the vlogging camera as well, so for a little while no no video, but I will try to make some photos with this camera. Oh, awesome find, so happy with this. So you might have seen there's a hornet as well. So if you want to find stag beetles, you need a forest with old oak, because those the larvae of those beetles will be in the ground feeding on old oak, yeah, root systems and everything which are in the ground, and after a few years they will come out. And then I think I'm no stag beetle expert, so if I am saying something which is not correct, let me know below. So the females will look for spots on oak trees where the tree is bleeding. And that's also where the males then are trying to find the females. There's this giant male stag beetle, and he is covering a female. And there were two other males which were much smaller. And yeah, but the big male is defending that female ferociously. The two other males, they are gone now. They've been going up the tree. The clouds are gone and it's really sunny now, and this place is in the sun. So let's see what the photos turned out. In the end, I did not really like the photos that my mobile phone made. I was unable to properly focus, and I also do not like the contrast and the sharpness that's being added. But to be honest, I did not like the photos I made with my vlogging camera either. So the next day I returned with my A7R4 together with my Laowa 10-18 wide angle. I really like these photos. They show a lot of the tree in the background, adding a lot of depth to the photos. That's it for this week's vlog, guys. I hope you liked it. If you did, a like and a comment would be much appreciated. And please, if you aren't subscribed already, please consider doing so. Do not forget to hit that notification bell, and then we will see each other again in my next vlog.